you're anything like me, you're probably skeptical about visualization techniques for success. After all, they're usually tied to law of attraction and related woo-woo. Well, let me cut to the chase and give you a new law. It's called the law of action. If you're not taking action, you probably ain't attracting much of anything. And yet, there are some visualization techniques I've used that I feel measurably, logically, and practically contributed to my success. And I'm very glad that the science convinced me to give them a try. Because I shudder to think of the very dark place my life would be if I'd missed the visualization technique for success and the story of its source I'll share with you today. It's called the treasure map, and I think you're gonna love it, so let's get started. Hi there, this is Dr. Anthony Metivier from MagneticMemoryMethod.com, where our community focuses on excellence for life through excellence in memory. Effective and efficient visualization is a huge part of how we do this. So if you're new here and want to improve all aspects of your life, get subscribed now. And for the love of memory, help me train the robots that humans still care about memory by hitting that thumbs up. Now, believe it or not, after getting my PhD in teaching and researching for a few years in Germany on a distinguished Mercator grant, I wound up nearly homeless. I got back to Canada, blew 3 job interviews at 3 major universities, and sat in a dark basement watching all my dreams go down the drain. I was also suffering from horrible dental mishap that really needed fixing. And as a skeptical uber atheist, the last thing I wanted were special visualization exercises. I was in physical pain on top of existential anxiety and needed a solution. But a visualization technique is what I found when I attended a special seminar designed to help people get jobs. It was pretty unusual to have someone with a PhD attend these things, but there I was one day cutting up images from a magazine to create what they were calling a treasure map. I watched in disgust as others in the seminar cut out expensive cars, homes, and jewelry, pasting them to big sheets of paper. I didn't want any of these things. I just wanted to teach at university again. I wanted to write books, not make cut-up art. So instead of wasting the time, I cut out eyes and teeth and made an abstract image of David Lynchian horror instead. And later, I revisited this exercise with a more open attitude, and what happened as a result was pretty amazing. So what changed? Well, it's a long story, and you can read the whole thing in The Victorious Mind, How to Master Memory, Meditation, and Mental Well-Being. But the long and short of it is this. I first changed my attitude. The traditional way of sending out resumes wasn't getting me anywhere, and I was starting to lose my desire to teach at universities anyway. I'd started a little film studies YouTube channel, and some of my books on screenwriting were starting to sell, leading to story consulting gigs. And as I studied how business works, I heard more and more people talking about vision boards and other visualization techniques that helped them out. Now, if some of the most successful people were doing it, maybe I was the one who needed to change. And so I did. But even though my mind started opening, it didn't open so much that my brains fell out. I wanted to know why these visualization techniques helped. So the first thing I did was to look at what the treasure map exercise is trying to get you to do, and that is to visualize a goal or an outcome. Now, since the magazines at the seminar were packed with images of people I didn't connect with, this was obviously a poor source to start from. I mean, I'm a long-haired professor who plays heavy metal bass. Not exactly going to relate to clippings from Elle magazine. And that's when I remembered reading about visualization in Richard Weissman's 59 Seconds. In this book, he talks about some research about how many people visualize impossible goals. For example, a person looking to get ripped might imagine Arnold Schwarzenegger's body even though they're ectomorphs, not mesomorphs. But even if you're an ectomorph like Bruce Lee, imagining yourself having his physique isn't going to help. What does help is imagining something like putting on your shoes and going to the gym. It's something you can actually do based on your existing abilities and your context. It's not the end goal, but it's one of the steps toward the process. So with this in mind, I thought deeply about my goals and my existing abilities. What strengths and opportunities did I have at that moment that could move me towards what I wanted to achieve? Now, there's another technique we might talk about in a future video that I was also practicing. It's called the perfect present visualization exercise. And if you want a video about it, please make sure I know about it loud and clear in the comments. And this exercise helped me focus with confidence that I really did want to write books for a living and find some way to teach on this new and strange thing called the internet. I also wanted to keep playing music, and for that, I would need a band. Finally, I wanted to travel the world, keep up my skills with card magic, fix my teeth, and find the love of my life. And to make all of these things a reality, I realized I really only had to focus on a few things. And those were the things that I placed on my treasure map. Instead of using magazines as the source, I used a personal photograph of the last time I played in a band. I used a plane flying over the ocean, some published books, Bach playing bass to remind me of my goals with learning his music, and a symbol for love and magic. Most importantly, I placed the image of a desk. Why a desk? Because people who want to write books and prepare scripts for video lectures need to sit at desks. So although I did visualize some parts of the outcome, I took care to also visualize what actually gets you the outcome. And sure, it's a word some people hate, but if you're on fire for a goal, work should never be a dirty word. The next step is to place the treasure map where you'll see it. I printed out several copies of my first treasure map and placed them in every room of the small basement suite I was living in. First thing in the morning, I saw it at least three times. It was on my bedroom wall. It was in the bathroom. I couldn't open the fridge or sit to eat breakfast without seeing it. The treasure map visualization technique has a uniqueness when it is used this way because it offloads the work onto your environment. Instead of meditating on mental imagery, you're literally seeing with your own eyes the map that leads you to your goal. The fact that it's in your environment makes it much harder to forget your goal. And because these images are individually selected and include something personal, it combines a happy memory with that special ingredient of reminding you to do the thing you need to do. In my case, it was writing. Without writing every single day, there would be no books or blog posts to publish, no scripts to film. For you, it might be something else. Whatever it is, arrange it on a piece of paper with a few other images that symbolize your ideal outcome. Then get a few copies into your environment. You can even make a smaller copy you place in your wallet or purse so you see it more often during the day. I used a variation of the treasure map technique when I was completing a program called the Brain Exercise Bootcamp. It's a very large learning experience that took months to complete. So that I never forgot my commitment to putting it together, I placed the mind map for the project on my desk. I didn't move it once until the project was done. Its visual presence in my environment made it impossible for me to forget my goal. So what ended up happening? Well, I got my dental implant, I got back to Europe, and I went on tour with my band. And I got a career as an author with many video courses, this YouTube channel, and more ideas for new books than I'll ever complete in a lifetime. And that's a very good thing. And if you'd like one of my most successful courses for free right now, head on over to magneticmemorymethod.com/YT to sign up for it. Thousands of people have improved their memory just by following its simple exercises, and you can too. It teaches you yet another kind of visualization technique, one that will improve your memory. And when it comes to visualization techniques for success, the trick for me, as it will surely be for you, is not just to complete the treasure map exercise. You need to match what you want with what you can realistically achieve based on your authentic desires, your existing competence, and how your competence assembles with the current historical context. Robert Greene talks about this in terms of amor fati, or loving your fate. As he once wrote to his email subscribers, "Be at one with your fate and give your actions the weight of eternity. Stop wishing for something else to happen, for a different fate. That is to live a false life. The power that you can have in life of accepting your fate is so immense that it is almost hard to fathom. It gives you real stillness and clarity and perspective." In collaboration with Ryan Holiday, Green has even created this Amor Fati coin you can carry with you to remind yourself of this principle. The coin is a memento, a memory technique, with a phrase which in its original Latin is a second person directive to remember. Remember your fate and love your fate. And that's what a good visualization technique should help you do. Remember your goals and remember to focus on the steps that will get you there. As my friend and colleague in memory training Nelson Dellis once said about how he climbs Mount Everest, don't focus on reaching the peak alone. Focus on the next place your hand needs to go. Thanks as ever for the view. Thanks to our channel members and everyone who has the Magnetic Memory Method Masterclass or any of my books for your ongoing interest and support. Everyone on Team Magnetic really, really appreciates the opportunity to serve. And if you want some more visualization training immediately, check out 5 visualization exercises for memory palace practice next.